From studios at the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, this is Fourth and State. A powerful business group wants to do something about Wisconsin's problem with job training. A chat with Linda Salchenberger of Competitive Wisconsin. I'm David Haynes. I'm the opinions editor of the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, and I'm joined today by Linda Salchenberger, who is provost, associate provost at Marquette University, and is a co-chair of a new report that is just being released this morning called Be Bold 2. The Be Bold 1 report looked at economic development strategies that the state should implement. Some of those are now in place, including the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation, WEDC, which was, we believe, an important thing that happened during the early months of the Walker administration. Be Bold 2, though, Linda, looks at talent creation and talent development. First of all, welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Well, building on what was accomplished through Be Bold 1, we next tackled what is an important, increasingly important job for or challenge for states all over the country. Mm-hmm. And that is how to better align talent development with economic development. Mm-hmm. So we've all noticed that there are lots of gaps these days in the skills that employers are looking for and the talents and skills that our students are graduating with. Mm-hmm. So we came up with three what we call big buckets or recommendations.
So three big ideas
to actually make this happen. Mm-hmm. And the first is really pretty simple. It is simply to align economic development with talent development. Mm-hmm. And this will be accomplished really in two tangible ways. The first is building on WEDC's mission. We believe that there's an opportunity for them to help create a talent council. Mm-hmm. And the talent council will have sole responsibility for trying to better match the skills gaps with all the initiatives mm-hmm. that take
so
place.
So a talent council would include members from, who would be on that talent council?
So currently there's a group called the Council on Workforce Investment.
Right, and that's Tim Sullivan's group.
That is Tim Sullivan's mm-hmm. group at the current time. And most of that membership would be, in our vision, part of this Talent Development Council. Mm-hmm. Reason we've chosen that group is because the right people are at the table. Mm-hmm. Educators, obviously government is represented, businesses and business organizations mm-hmm. are represented.
Labor is at the table too.
So yeah. We think that's a good place for that discussion to take place in a systematic and a sustained way. Mm-hmm. The mm-hmm. second piece is, they can't accomplish anything unless they have sufficient funding.
Right.
So we are actually recommending that a talent development fund be created mm-hmm. And managed by them. And we are recommending that it be $100
million. $100 million. Now,
yeah.
Right now, Wisconsin spends about how much?
About
$15 million. So yeah. A significant increase. How would that compare with, say, surrounding states?
Well, for example, we looked at Minnesota, which mm-hmm. is now up to $87
million. Okay.
So we really feel we have the opportunity to become competitive and, in fact, leapfrog.
And we're not really competitive right now in terms of funding.
We are not.
Okay. What would that money be used for?
We envision it, and again, we'll leave it up to others to create the actual tactical details, but we envision partnerships. That mm-hmm. is, a local business notices that there's a skills gap in his or her area mm-hmm. and creates some sort of a partnership with some training organization and or an educational institution, and together they approach or create a proposal for the Talent Development Council.
Mm-hmm. And the what's the process going forward for Be Bold 2? You've got the report now. I think you plan some economic summits also later this year. What do you hope to accomplish there?
Well, the process has been inclusive from day one. So okay. The important thing here is to listen to and act on everybody's input. And the economic summits will be designed to sort of take this idea to the marketplace mm-hmm. and then also create more strategies around how to actually accomplish the goals of the paper.
Mm-hmm. And I think you have one coming up in Waukesha in, what, late November?
We do. December? November 15th is the day.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And after that, after you've had the summits, you've gathered that additional information, then what happens?
Well, one anticipates that there'll be opportunity for legislators to act on some of these ideas, and so we're hoping to get continue to work through that process.
So to present to the administration and legislative leaders, and I think you have some legislative leaders already on board, at least in terms of being aware of it and having been involved.
We do. There are several members from both sides of the House and from the Senate and also the House on our committee.
Yeah, I think you mentioned Tim Cullen, Senator, Democrat from Kenosha, Alberta Darling, Republican from River Hills, are both involved. Now talk finally about one other piece of this. You would like to create a website or maybe an app for, like an iPad, where people, either businesses or if I'm about to lose my job, I could go and sort of get some information about what's out there. What would be there? What kinds of information might I see?
Yeah. So first and foremost, we envision a consolidated data warehouse consisting of information related to jobs. So mm-hmm. there's some part of, you know, what jobs are available, but also careers. So mm-hmm. If you have a certain skill set and are unemployed and are looking for other job opportunities, this data warehouse that you might access through an app would tell you what sort of training you might need and even where you might get it. Mm-hmm. So it's intended to sort of pull together all of the information related to either current or, you know, the jobs that will be much demanded in the future and how you can get the skill sets to be qualified for those jobs.
And so in a way you're sort of going where the people are, especially younger people, and using social media and using apps and their cell phone and so forth.
Exactly. In the study we identified five skills clusters, and mm-hmm. those skills clusters by and large demand certain skill sets be developed as early as middle school. And so we mm-hmm. again want to encourage students to learn and understand what skills they need in order to be employable upon graduation.
And STEM skills, science, technology, engineering, and math are huge.
Without a doubt. So this is the jobs of the future, for the most part, are going to require some set of those skills. And so it's really important that students don't make wrong decisions early on about not taking that math or science course.
Right. So take calculus if you're thinking about it. Definitely take it. Well, Linda Salchenberger from Marquette, thanks so much for being with us on 4th and State. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.